Hello everybody, welcome to the Scratch tutorial. In this video, I'm going to set up a key response game. So when I'm not able to press the key correctly, I will see a message telling me the answer is wrong. Otherwise, I'm able to see that the message tells me I have pressed the key correctly. If I haven't pressed any key for a long time, the cat will say that I have given no input to the game. Now, let's start the project. First, I would like to set up the background. How about using the hay field, like this one? And I would like to position the cat to the left-hand side of the screen. When the flag is clicked, I want to set the position of the cat. Okay, when I click the flag, the cat is put to the left-hand side at this coordinate, x for -180 and y for -30. And then I would like to set up the letters that are going to be pressed. I go to the sprites. I want to choose the letters so I can click on A. So for example, if I have this character, I can do something like this. When this letter is clicked, I want to set its position to the middle. So let me see. If I click on the flag, the letter is put in the middle of the screen, okay. And I would also like to hide the character once it is set in the middle position of the screen. So you see, when I click on it, the letter is hidden immediately after the position is set. Because I want the letters to be shown when the looping begins, I don't let the letters show up just before the loop begins, okay? So I can do similar things for other letters. I choose B, C, and D. And then I can just copy the flags to other letters. So now you see that all A, B, C, and D would have the original positions in the middle of the screen, and it can hide when the position is set immediately. A is here, B is here, C is here, and D is here. And after that, I want to do the most important part of the game. I need to go back to the cat first. When the cat is clicked, I really want the letters to show up randomly. So how can I set up this random choice of the letters? Let me show you my way now. When the flag is clicked, the cat is put in the screen here, and it will also do something like this one. I really want to record the number of correct presses, so before doing so, I really have to set up such a variable. The variable can be called correct. It is for all the sprites. So the initial number of correct presses is just 0. And then I can do a loop, which is a forever loop. Since I really want to record the time elapsed, I really want to set up a timer. So the timer is started from the beginning of each of the letters. I also want to check whether a certain key is pressed or not, be it a correct one or an incorrect one. So I really have to set up a variable called pressed. It is for all the sprites. If a key is pressed, I really want to set up the variable to be 1, otherwise I just keep it as 0. And then I really want to pick up a letter from A, B, C, or D. I set up a variable first called letter, which is for all the sprites. Since I want to get a random letter, I just pick up a random number from 1 to 4, and then each of the numbers represents each of the possible letters. So 1 can represent A, 2 can represent B, 3 can represent C, and 4 can represent D. If the letter picked up as 1, I would like to show the character A. And also I can just hide the two variables called pressed and letter. Hide. Okay. And when the letter is 1, then I want to show A. How can I do it? Let me show you my way. I want to tell the letter A to show up. So that's why I have set up a broadcast message to the letter A. The message is called show A. And when this message is broadcast, I have to tell letter A to do something. So when the letter A receives the message broadcast by the sprite called cat, I would like to do something. I would like to hide the letter first. And then I would like to wait for 0.3 seconds. After that, I want to show that letter to the player. And we will see the effects after I really play that game. And of course, you can expect that I would have similar actions to the remaining three letters. So I can do something like this. I just copy this flow to the following three letters, B, C, and D. And I just change the broadcast message to show B, show C, and show D. Okay, I changed the message to show B, which can be used later. Okay, let me go back to the sprite called cat. Okay, after the broadcast to tell the letter A to show up, I can do something like this now. I just want to allow the letter to show for 1 second only. So during this 1 second period, I really want to check whether the target letter is pressed or not. So I have set up a certain block to help me check this key pressing. It's called check answer, and there is a certain input, which is a Boolean variable. And how is it going to do? I want to see whether the key is pressed or not. Okay, how can I do this block? I can use a conditional statement. If any key is pressed, then I have to do the checking. If a certain letter is pressed, and at the same time, the key pressed is the correct one, which is according to the letter shown up on the screen. So if the letter is pressed and the pressed variable becomes 1, it means that the key is already pressed, whether or not it refers to the correct letter shown on the screen or not. If the correct letter is pressed, I have to increase the number of correct answers by 1. So you can expect that this block is something like this shown here. If the letter obtained from the random number generator is 1, I want to see whether the key A is pressed or not correctly. And then you can see that its letter pressed corresponds to this position. So here I want to see whether the key A is pressed or not correctly. If it is correct, I will just increase the number of correct answers by 1. If A is not pressed but other keys are pressed, this condition fails even though the second part becomes true, just because the first part is false in the situation. Then I would also like to say correct for 2 seconds. It is better to use if else statements. What else if the key pressed is not correct? Then I just say. So it seems like if the letter isn't really the correct one shown on the screen, I would say wrong. How can I know this situation? I can just use the pressed variable. If the letter is pressed, this variable becomes 1. And I would like to check whether that pressed key corresponds to the correct answer. And then how about the next part of the if part on the left hand side? I want to set up another block called say no input. I want to put it here. So what does it mean? If the time is larger than 1, it means that the player has not really pressed any key. Then the cat has to do some response. How can I do it? Let me show you my way. I have to really define that one shown here. Okay, this one. And for this block, I would like to use an if statement. If nothing is really pressed, the variable called pressed is still 0. Then I just say no input for 2 seconds. Okay. And after saying no input, I would like to tell the letter to hide. And the broadcast message is called hide A. And of course, I have to tell the letter A to do something in response to this broadcast message. When I receive the message coming from the cat, I just want to hide the letter, so I use hide. Similarly, you can expect that the remaining 3 letters would have to do similar things. So I just copy this operation to the 3 other letters. Of course, I have to change it to hide B. For this one, I change it to hide C. Hide B for this one. And how will I use hide B, hide C, and hide D? I'm going to use it now. Let me go back to the cat. You see that I can just do similar things for letters represented by 2, 3, and 4, respectively. So let me duplicate the block. I put it here. I put it back first. If I want to correspond to the second letter, which is B, I just say letter is equal to 2. I change it to show B. Key B pressed. And hide B. And then I can do similar things for C and D. So let me duplicate block. Show C. Key C pressed. Hide C. Finally, I can do some similar things for letter D. Duplicate. Number 4. Show D. Key D pressed. And hide D. Okay, I just put all these 4 blocks together in the forever loop. Okay, so the program is complete. I would like to play with it first. Oh, I found that I missed one statement. If any key is pressed, I want to set the pressed variable to 1 so that I can get rid of any further input from the keyboard. So let me see again. No input for now because I haven't pressed any key. Yes, when I pressed C correctly within 1 second, I would get the correct message coming from the cat. So how about if I pressed any letter wrongly? Let me try again. I pressed other letters, so I get wrong. Wrong again because I pressed another letter other than A. If I pressed any key wrong, I'm not able to correct my answer immediately because of this statement. I have to check whether a certain key is pressed, and at the same time, I want to see whether that key corresponds to the letter picked up from the random number generator. If they don't match, I would not allow any further input so that the player can no longer correct the answer after he or she has pressed any of the keys. So that is the major idea of the whole game. You can see that the game is quite simple. I have to do the checking very carefully so that I disallow any further input if the answer is already wrong. And I would like to show the message correctly to the player to see whether the player has really pressed the key shown on the screen correctly or not. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.